Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Just hang on.
This is a tree. Yeah, it's not pulling. Oh no, it's a bass. Brian, get the net. Oh my god. Oh my lord. That's a big one, bro. That's a big one. That is a big
one. He won't even move him, dude.
No, he ain't.
Alright, give him some line.
Yep, I am.
Holy cow.
Alright, coming up to the boat.
Which way is it coming?
Right here. He's right here.
Oh, I see him.
Oh my word. That is a big one.
Is it a bass?
Yeah, oh yeah, it's a bass.
Oh!
Oh man, that's a big one, bro. Golly. Oh, had too much pressure on him.
Hey, what's happening, guys? It's Brian and Jim here again. We get out fishing, and we have just come off the lake at Shearon Harris. Sorry about the dark video, but we want to just touch base with you guys and tell you what was happening out here. It is, second week of March now.
Yep.
Temperatures got up outside just a little bit, and it's got the water temperature just about to that right range for the pre-spawn. And we saw the first of that tonight out here. And you see what Jim just had on the line there just a minute ago, and lost it at the boat, probably at least a 5-pounder.
Yeah, that was all my fault. I got a little excited and should have gave him some line and didn't, or her. But, that's the way fishing is. You just got to let it go and keep on moving.
Well, there are some giant bass. If you guys are familiar with Shearon Harris at all, you'll know you can catch a fish of a lifetime in this lake. But a lot of people struggle to fish Shearon Harris Lake. And I will tell you, one of the things we use, if you don't have it in your tackle box, you need to get it. And we'll put a link down in the description. But if you don't have a crawdad colored lipless crankbait of some sort, Jim uses a red-eye shad. That's what he caught his fish on tonight.
Strike King.
From Strike King. If you don't have one of those, you need one. Run the bait parallel to the sawgrass or whatever you call it out here. Usually they'll hit on it about a second or two after it hits the water. You start reeling it, just keep a slow, steady retrieve on it, and they'll wear it out. We'll show you guys some footage of another one Jim caught tonight, and take a look at it here.
Yeah, nice. Oh, come on. All right, stay with him. Just be easy with him. Just be easy with him. Oh my gosh, dude.
Son. Look at
that. Come on, come on. Bring him up. Bring him this way. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
That's awesome, dude.
Ooh, watch out.
All right.
Ryan, let's get you a picture of this thing real quick. Hold on.
I gotta stop the video, get the photo. Boom. Let's get a close up of that thing.
Pounds is what I'm guessing?
Yeah, it's easy, 3.5 pounds. Sweet, man. Get her done. Hold on, I'm gonna get her. Nice fish. What is that? Are you sure? That's a bowfin.
No, that's a bowfin.
Wow, holy crap. That might be what's in here working.
Oh, they got teeth.
Yeah, I'm not not gonna reach in there. I don't care, I caught a fish.
That's a big old bowfin, brother.
Man. Oh, hey, easy now. I wouldn't be surprised if that's what's been jacking me up all along.
Oh, that's not good. Turn on my bolt.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in again to Get Out Fishing. And if you hadn't noticed, we've got some new merch on our website, getoutfishing.net. Go and check that out. And drop us a line on Facebook if you do. First time you found us, hit like and subscribe. And thanks for following along. Get Out Fishing.